Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is October 15th, 2011, and people, it's a very significant day in my history. Today, 19 years ago, this was what the worst day in my history. Because people, 19 years ago, on October 15th, 1992, I was wrongfully convicted for attempted murder. You can see them right there. Because people, these four guys had the audacity to come to my home, with guns, right? And put gun to my head and try to rob me. Actually, they robbed me. Robbed me, took all my money, my jewelry, my clothes, my equipment, and told me they're gonna blow my brains out if I didn't cooperate with them. So they got my money and everything. 2 weeks later, February 15th, they had the audacity to come back again. So this time, one of them got shot with a 12-gauge shotgun. But instead of the law holding me up and backing me up, they convicted me, they indicted me, prosecuted me and convicted me, and gave me 9 to 12 years in prison. And it was the worst day of my life. But however, while I was in prison, in 1994, they threw up, they dismissed my appeal. See, my appeal was dismissed, 1994. Okay? So I fired my attorneys. Okay? And people, in 1994, right, I had a vision. My lawyer said to me, said, my son, I didn't send you to prison to punish you. I didn't send you to prison because you did anything wrong. He said, my son, I sent you to prison for a reason. Because in the future, some terrible nations, some terrible people, Japan is one of them, and the Zionists, the rich men of the world, they're going to take revenge on America. They're going to invest heavily in America's infrastructure. They're going to invest in your homes, in your mortgages, in the infrastructure, in the market. They're going to invest heavily, and then they're going to build up your market. Then they're going to collapse it. They're going to pull it out from under America's feet and collapse it. And it's going to cause chaos, bloodshed, violence. He said, you, my son, I brought you to prison so that you could learn the law, so you could fight it, you could try to stop it. Just fight it, my son. I didn't put you in prison because I hate you. You did no wrong. You did no evil. You are innocent in my eyes. You are a hero. But I must put you in prison, because if not, people are going to try to hurt you. They're going to try to take revenge on you and kill you. So I'm going to put you in here to protect you. And while you're in here, you're going to learn the law. And you're going to fight what's coming in the future. And people, I learned the law. And in 1995... In 1996, I overturned the case, okay? I overturned my conviction. Even though my appeal was dismissed, I got a new trial, okay? I appealed and I won a new trial. I got a new trial. And they never retried me because I beat them free and square, okay? So, anyway, so now, after I bought my house, and people, this is the proof right here. See the case? 10, 15, 1994, my appeal was dismissed. I was convicted in 10, 15. And now, I came, people, and I filed a lawsuit. I came and I bought a house, people. And just what my lawyer told me would happen, happened. The banks committed fraud against all the people. And the rug was pulled from under America's feet, and it market collapsed. But before that, the World Trade Center was knocked down. Just as my vision said. Okay, and I'll show you how I found it in the Bible also. So it's true. Anyway, so it happened, people, and I was prepared. Not for 9/11, because I was sleeping when it happened. I was probably the last person to know about 9/11. I found out like after 12 o'clock in the afternoon. But the mortgages, I wasn't asleep, I was waiting for it. This time I was waiting. So anyway, I file a case, a suit against the banks and the judges. I won in the Brockton District Court, and when I won that case, I decided to fight for all the people, so I took it to the federal court, and I won, but because I refused to take the deal, and I said to fight for everybody, because that's what my lawyer told me, I had to fight for everybody, and because I did that, the judges now ruled against me, and gave my house to the bank, say the bank didn't commit any fraud. People, all of you know that the banks commit fraud against all the people. So what's up with these crazy ass judges? These judges are crazy, they are nuts. Judge Woodlock, Judge Torello, Borden and Thompson, they are nuts. They are nuts. People, everybody in America knows. They know that these judges commit fraud against all the people. They know it. Not the judge, these banks commit fraud against all the people. But these crazy judges gonna give my house away to the banks. But people, don't you all know? My lord already warned me. He warned me. He said, Paul, you'll be a fool if you really think that these judges are gonna listen to you. He said, no, my son, you know what I'm doing? I'm showing you that you can't have any mercy on people like this, because you're gonna show them love. And in return for your love, they're gonna show you hatred. You're gonna show them truth, but they won't accept the truth. They're gonna try to bamboozle you with lies. He said, I'm gonna show you what mankind really is all about. I'm gonna show you why I would never send anyone to die for them. I will show you why I will never send Jesus Christ to die for these men, because these men are like dogs. You feel sorry for them, and they'll turn around and bite you. Okay? They're like dogs. They're like sharks. When they smell blood, they turn around and bite you. So, people, I don't care much your dog love you, but cut yourself and go to sleep. And see if your dog won't probably, and your dog is hungry, see if he won't eat you alive. Most dogs will do that. Okay? Sorry for Magadog. Magadog turn around and bite you. So, he said, no matter how much you fight for these people, no matter how much you show them the truth, Paul, they're going to laugh at you. They're going to tell you you're wrong. Even when you're right, they're going to tell you you're wrong. So, the point is, I'm just letting you see, because there's something about you that you're going to know, find out. And you're going to have to judge these men. You're going to have to judge them. And I know you. You're not an evil person. I know you're going to feel sorry for them. But you got to know the truth about them. Because can an evil heart be made pure? Can an evil man, my son, be made pure? And I said, yes, my Lord. He said, ha, you'll see. They could be made pure, but you're going to see what it's going to take for them to be made pure. So I'm going to let you go along your own path. Learn the law and fight them, but you're going to be very disappointed. You're going to be very, very disappointed. But it's for you to learn so that you're going to know how to judge them when your time comes. Because yes, I have chosen you. I have chosen you to be the judge of these men on earth. And you have to know them to judge them. So, people, so how are we going to get them to go against me if I show them the law? They're going to go over the law and say, no, harden their hearts. Don't be nice to them, because if you be nice to them, they're going to take advantage of you, and they're going to give you your house, and they're going to make you shut up and not help everyone else. So in order for you not to get them to rule on your behalf alone, you got to reject everything they give you, and don't be afraid to speak out against them. Even if you have to disrespect them, as long as it's the truth, do not be afraid, because the truth is an offense, but it is not a sin. You commit no sin if you disrespect them, as long as you tell the truth. So he said, my son, just harden their hearts. Everyone who's trying to help you, harden their hearts, because they're not really trying to help you. They're trying to control you. They're trying to make you calm so you won't fight. So don't take nothing they give you. Don't take their briberies. If they offer you $100 million, don't take it, because you say $100 million, if you stand up for the people, money will be no object, because our plan is to eradicate money from our society. Say, don't worry about money. It will come to nothing soon. Just fight for the people, okay? And don't compromise with the devil, because if you compromise with the devil, then his handout is going to be in the details, okay? He said the devil handout is going to be in the details, so do not compromise with him. If he want to be nice to you, harden his heart. Make it difficult for him to be nice. Because he's not really nice. He's not really nice. Because in one hand, he give you bread. And the next one is a snake. Okay? So, don't trust him. Harden his heart. Harden his heart against you. Unless he going to fight for all the people. Unless the judges and the government going to give equal rights to all the people. Do not accept it. Fight them. Stand up for all the people, my son. Stand up. Okay? And if you fail once, stop and fight again. If you fail twice, stop and fight again. If you fail three times, stop and fight again. And I said, my Lord, how much longer can I fight? And he said, fight until Babylon fall. He said, because what if you knock once and nothing happened? You knock three times, four times, five times. And it's going to be the seventh time you're going to fall. And you step at the sixth. How are you going to feel knowing, wow, if I'd gone number seven, it would have fallen. So he said, my son, don't stop until Babylon fall. March them down. Don't stop until Babylon fall. And people, Babylon is falling. Babylon is falling. Okay? Look at all over the world. Rome. People marching in Rome. Washington DC. All over the world. Didn't I tell you all it's gonna revolution gonna come be a world? I told you all it's gonna be a worldwide revolution. People. Okay? You see the dates? 10-15. They convicted me. 94. They denied my appeal. But I came out. And now look, everything my Lord told me would happen. These judges, even when you show them the truth, they laugh at it. But they're honorable men. They pat themselves on their shoulders. We are honorable. How can you be honorable when you look at the truth and you scoff at it? How can you call yourself honorable man? You're not honorable man. You have made a mockery out of the system. These three judges, along with Judge Woodlock, Judge Douglas Woodlock, you have made a mockery out of the system. How can you call yourself honorable men? How can you call yourself judges when you see the truth, but you discard the truth for lies and bribery, for lies, and to look at yourself and pat yourself on the back and say, we are honorable men. You shall not put me down, judges. You shall not put me down. Don't you know, I have already won against you because I've shown the people that even when you see truth, that you will set your face against the truth for a lie. Don't you know, you can never defeat the truth? How the hell can any one of you think, you simple men, think you could ever, ever defeat the truth? I am the truth. I am the way. And I am the light. Because in 2007, when everyone was sleeping, Paul Mark was in your court telling you what the banks were doing.
They'll know and understand.
Look at all the news. Look at it. Who did y'all see until beating the drums? No one. 2007, Paul Mark was in the court. Paul Mark was on the news telling people, fight, don't give up. Paul Mark was there. So, I knew. So do you think that you could defeat me? My 2-year-old son, when he was 2 years old, he used to tell me, Daddy, fight for all the people. Daddy, no one's gonna kill you, Daddy. Daddy, no one's gonna take our house from us, Daddy. I swear to y'all, my son was 2 and he used to speak to me like an adult. He used to scare me. I used to go and check the house, see if these people have bombs in my house. I used to be so afraid. I used to go check the basement. One day my son, I'm on the phone telling my mother that I was scared that I think the gas man gonna blow up my gas meter. I go come upstairs and tell my son, I'll be right back, I'm going to the basement. My son start yelling, Daddy, you going in the basement to check any plugs, Daddy? Daddy, they're gonna kill you, Daddy? They're gonna blow you up, Daddy? Daddy, what did I tell you? Didn't I tell you God gonna protect you, Daddy? What did I tell you, Daddy? And he's pointing his finger at me. Daddy, what did I tell you, Daddy? Daddy, can God protect you, Daddy? Daddy, what did I tell you? Your people, I was shook. I started crying. Because that was my son. Yo, he gave me one tongue lashing. But how did he know where I was going? My son have never been in a basement. But you know what? I was whispering to my mother and he knew. My son, he was 2 years then. He knew. And he gave me a tongue lashing. He said, Daddy, what did I tell you? God gonna protect you, Daddy. Daddy, no one gonna hurt you, Daddy. No one gonna kill you, Daddy. No one gonna blow up the house, Daddy. Okay? Fight for all the people, Daddy. Because God is with you, Daddy. Daddy, don't you think God can protect you, Daddy? Don't you think God can protect you, Daddy? Yo, I swear to you people, I swear on my life, I cried because this little kid, Wow. And anyone who knows him, ask and they'll tell you, that's not a little boy, that's an old soul. He commands your attention, Elijah. So, judges, do you think I could be afraid of you? Do you think you could defeat me? Oh, you little man. I'm not afraid of you. Because, guess what? You take my death for you to defeat me. Not even prison could defeat me. You take my death. Okay? So,